Hey guys, IKhanwhisper here with another Mass Effect Andromeda video. This is just picking up after where we left off in the last one, having just arrived on the Nexus. I just kinda picked some parts I thought were interesting and wanted to talk about. Right here, they're talking about the genophage, which is a biological engineered virus type thing that greatly lowers the fertility rate of the Krogan. So, if you remember from the previous games, the Krogan were kind of like elevated by the Salarians into an advanced society, and they were used to fight the Rachni, that bug species. And after they had dealt with the Rachni, they became a threat to the galaxy themselves, and everyone had to band together to fight them. And they're kind of like the grunts from Halo, where they breed super quickly. I think the females like had up to 1,000 Krogans a year or something. So and now the fertility rate is like 1 in 1,000. So if you actually think about it, it doesn't sound so bad if they can have up to 1,000. That averages out to maybe 1 a year. So if you do the math, that didn't sound so bad, but apparently it's devastating to them. So that was that part. Here we're catching up with the director Dan here, who's in charge of the station. I think we're gonna learn about more of the troubles going on here. So, lots of bad stuff has befallen the station before our arrival. We were supposed to be in the clear when we got here, but apparently, whatever arc these guys were on, or I don't know if they just flew out here with the station, but they hit the Scourge as well, that energy cloud. And it took out a lot of people and damaged a lot of systems. So they've only assassin guy was that, I forget his name, but in Mass Effect 3, I believe, and got distracted thinking of Quarian and Kunari and how those words are similar. But and the Hanar are those floating jellyfish species. And apparently the Drell, where their home world was dying, and the Hanar rescued them and brought them back, and kinda came together and merged, and their societies lived together. But the Drell have to live in these kinda biodome environments because the Hanar come from a water world where like 90% is water. I don't know, something like that. And the Drell is a desert world, and too much exposure to the water would actually be lethal to them. It causes a illness for them. And here we get one of our first quests from the Nexus. Someone has been found guilty of the first murder in the Andromeda galaxy, and his wife here is asking us to investigate that because she doesn't think it could be true. So we have to go investigate this, since this case could set a precedent for how things are carried out in this new galaxy, and we want to ensure that justice is served here. So we'll agree to this one, and we have to do a little run around on the station here, talk to a few people, investigate some things before we actually go to the planet and investigate further. But I'll just show a little bit of it here and skip out some of the boring parts. There was a lot of running around and talking to people here, but here's Rensis, the guy accused of murder. It's kind of weird selecting the chat option with the little heart on it when it, I don't know. It's kind of like the optimistic one, but it's weird that it has a little heart. Like, I'm not flirting with this guy. But, this guy, he had an argument with the head of the colony who wanted to stay there and fight back against the Ket. And this guy said that they should just leave because the colony was lost. And then they were under attack and in a sandstorm. And he fired at something. And then the leader of the colony guy ended up dead. So everyone just assumed that he murdered him. So he's claiming it was an accident. So we'll investigate for him. He doesn't seem very enthusiastic about us helping him, but he should be. On here we have the famous line. Sorry, my face is tired from dealing with this. If you've seen anything from this game, you've probably seen a video making fun of that. Doesn't really make any sense. But, I don't know, it's kind of funny. I think it's more funny than anything bad with the game. Look at her hair, there's like, her hair looks weird. Looks like part of her head's missing. And then there's just little hairs. I don't know. But, so they've tried to colonize for 14 months, and it's been failing. and he suspects that there is sabotage going on, because there were things like that back when the mutiny was going on. So, we offered to help investigate with this guy. And I'll show some of this quest, but mostly because I just want to talk about it. It was pretty boring, though. A lot of these first quests on the Nexus were kind of boring, especially this one. Kind of gives you the runaround where you have to go back and forth between all around the Nexus and to the Ark and back again. Which, I don't know why they lead with quests like this where they're not that fun and just make you run around right off the bat. Kind of messes with the pacing of the game. But the game picks up once you leave the Nexus. And it kind of introduces you to more of this, using your scanner to locate things, which you'll use more often later as well. So we're collecting more evidence that sabotage is actually happening, and we have to follow the wires here to locate all of them. I don't know why I was so jerky with the camera there, but we just confirmed that it is sabotage, and it points to Zara. So we have to leave the Nexus and go to the Hyperion now. For no reason, but yeah. Here we go. Here's Zara. So we talk to her, and it finds out that she's investigating the same thing, and someone likely set her up, because her evidence pointed to Raj, the first guy, doing the sabotage. So, that means we gotta go back to the Hyperion. I mean, not the Hyperion, the Nexus, and investigate more. So, I'm not sure why they chose to start you off with these quests. And like I said, it kind of makes the pacing weird right off the bat. I kind of ran into the same thing with Dragon Age Inquisition at first, where I forget the name of the first zone, but you go to the first zone and you kind of do your main story quest, and then I don't know, I like exploring everywhere I can, so I just start exploring that first zone, and it's a huge zone, and you just, I don't know, it messes with the pacing when you just keep encountering boring kind of cookie cutter side quests and open worlds. So it becomes more fun once you get past that and into the story. But I do like exploring in the game. So, we've tracked down through the security tapes to this guy, to Dale Gribble here. And after all this run around, this quest kind of has a meh ending as well. So this guy is kind of butthurt about the exiles being kicked off and the mutiny and stuff. And you confront him and say that you can't go around trying to blow up people just because you're butthurt. And then he's like, meh, what are you gonna do about it? And then you just say, well, it's not my call. And then he walks off all chill and nothing comes of it. So you track down the saboteur and then nothing happens of it. He's not really arrested. He just strolls off here. Look at him. But here we jump forward a little bit, talking to Sam. And, let's see what to talk about here. So we have that personal connection, since he kind of merges with the Pathfinder. And that's us now, since our dad switched that over and our brain stopped working, so we needed it. But he's revealing here that there's special things called profiles, which enhance certain abilities, and you can switch between it. Which, you start with a couple unlocked, and by putting points in different categories, you unlock the others. Which, they're pretty easy to unlock. It doesn't require too many points. And he's talking about some symbiotic relationship where he learns human stuff and sees the world, and you benefit because he boosts your combat ability and your hacking ability and stuff, which is kind of cool. Just reminded me of, it's not even really very closely related, but a Mechanicum tech priest in one of the Warhammer 40k books had multiple brains that he had memory stored in, and he was trying to remember something about this one planet, and he was like, that seems kind of familiar, and then he like switched out brains and put a different one in, and was like, oh yeah, the Necrons are on that planet now, I remember, and I remember how to fight them now. That's pretty interesting. It's like he had it on an external hard drive, but he switched out brains. So now we got access to Papa Ryder's personal quarters here. He has his gun collection here from when he was fighting in the First Contact Wars, where the humans fought the Turians. A fierce conflict. It's interesting how it usually works out when two different cultures or civilizations, I guess, meet each other. Usually leads to battles right off the bat. Each other or something, assert dominance. Not really sure why the Turians attacked. So that little floating green thing was a memory marker thing that you have to collect a bunch of them, and it unlocks Sam's memories. So we did that, and now we get to run over here and unlock a memory. Okay, so you can see your dad's memories because Sam had access to them because he was in your dad's head pretty much. So yeah, we get to have a look at that, and it's a fairly interesting one. So, essentially a flashback here, and he's talking about using his research to give humanity pace with everybody else or give him a leg up by doing what he's currently doing and having AI in everyone's heads. But using AI, I think even making AI is supposed to be illegal. Well, maybe not all AI, but I think they say here it's illegal. Definitely to put them in your head like that is illegal in the Mass Effect universe. I remember a mission in Mass Effect 1, I think. Maybe it was 2. I don't know. One of the first ones where there's like a rogue AI on the moon. And you have to go there and put an end to that. Because it took over a military base or something. So they deny his research. But obviously he continues it. And is already using it. And here's Mama Ryder. And it comes out that she has a terminal illness. And that explains why she's not with them currently. But now our time on the Nexus is finally over. The ship they granted us. I'm surprised they have this cool ship, the Tempest, just lying around and haven't put it to use. I guess it was waiting for a Pathfinder. So that's a pretty cool ship. A good replacement for the Normandy, I guess. And here's Vetra, our new companion that we're being introduced to here. Kind of like a mercenary soldier type person working for the initiative. And she's pretty cool. You'll see I use her instead of Liam, I think his name is, but she's pretty interesting. And even though we got clearance from everybody to use this ship and go do Pathfinder stuff, Addison, with her tired face, is trying to hold us up here. Vetra kind of bribes him by saying she can get his family, or whoever it is, I forgot, I didn't read it, out of cryo earlier. It's his brother, son, something. Her tactical visor there is kind of cool. So, settled, we can keep moving, get off planet, and get on with the interesting part of the game. I know this video didn't have any combat in it, but there were some things I wanted to talk about in it, so I thought it was better to show it anyway. There was a little awkward bit there of me checking that it was still recording and how long the video was. But here we see the inside of the ship and some of the crew. Glad they still had that little potted plant over there to make it homey. So we are ready to explore the galaxy. A little 3D thing of the Nexus. not as cool as the Citadel. Only has two things spread out and not four arms, so clearly only half as cool. There we walked across that unnecessarily dangerous little hollow bridge. Not sure why that has to be there. But here's the bridge, and we get introduced to the pilot, the Solarian Kalo. Or Kalo. Kalo's probably right. I forget how he says it. But he's a pretty interesting character. I haven't talked to him much, but he seems pretty cool from this. And doesn't have an annoying voice, which is definitely good. A lot of the people on the Nexus, I thought, had kind of annoying voices. But apparently he was a designer and test pilot of this ship. And he was the only one out of that people designing it to come to Andromeda to see it put to use. So that's pretty cool. Probably not as cool as Seth Green as Joker from the original Mass Effect games, but he seems pretty good so far. Oh, you can see the landscape in the distance kind of curving up, which is pretty cool. Kind of like in the Halo games, how the world kind of is a ring, and you can see around in the inside how there's plant life and buildings and stuff. So we're having an inspirational speech here. Never planned to be Pathfinder, but we're the Milky Way's best and brightest. Okay, so here we go, taking off. Pretty cool animation here. It's a nice looking ship. Going out into space. System that it's in and bending the light around it. So I think having like an awesome detailed 3D map like this is pretty cool. I think if in schools they had access to something like that for all our solar system and planets that we have pictures of and stuff, that would be pretty cool. Get kids and people excited about science and stuff. But in a video game, it gets Sean, we were zoomed in, like, right on the outside of the planet there. Like, if you could zoom in even closer to the planet, that'd be cool. But here we have a wrecked starship. Looks like a shuttle. And now we are heading to Eos. So I do like the graphics in this game. He's making a funny face right now. But, yeah, the facial expressions currently aren't too expressive, but honestly it doesn't bother me. The gameplay and the story are pretty cool so far. And I love sci-fis, so I'm interested in it already. So here we go. Being put to the test for the first time as Pathfinder. About to land on the planet. Find out what happened to the first colony. This is where I'm going to stop this video. The next one's going to have a lot more combat and interesting things going on. So look forward to that. Hope you enjoyed the video. Leave a like or a comment if you did. And I will see you guys next time.